All right, today's blog is about the fact that you are responsible for creating value in every interaction you ever have with your client, starting from the first phone call. The first phone call for a lot of people sounds like this. It's terribly old school, and it is a legacy approach to prospecting, where they say something like, "Love to stop by, tell you about my company, share with you how our solutions work, some of the companies that were just like you we're working with right now, and I'd love to learn a little bit about your business." Okay, there is no value proposition there for me as the buyer, so that's not gonna work. Instead, you're gonna say, "I wanna share with you the four trends that we're carefully following that we believe are gonna have the biggest impact on your industry over the next 18 to 24 months. And listen, even if there's not a next step for us, I'd love to get your insights about how this is showing up in your world. And I'll leave you with the slide deck so you can challenge your team with some of these ideas. And you'll know us and we'll know you. What do you look like Thursday afternoon for an executive briefing?" Okay, I'm trying to offer value here. So this is the trading value rule. If you take someone's time, you're responsible for creating value for that other human being or human beings as the case might be. Okay, so that's number one. Now you get into discovery. So what do? You help them explore the case for change. You help them understand where their results are and how better results are available to them. And you start having that conversation, which is a really easy conversation to get into, because generally, once you start talking about big ideas, people start to engage and they'll tell you, "Oh, this is the way it's showing up in our world, and what are you seeing?" And then you get into a good conversation where you're a business person and you're consultative and you're acting and you sound like a trusted advisor. All these things are critically important. You'll get into further discovery, but one of the things that you can do to create value in that further discovery is to say, "Who else is going to need to be part of this conversation in order for us to move forward and for order for us to be able to generate the results we're talking about?" Okay, so that's a way you create value, by controlling the process. Part of discovery is solutioning, but what a lot of people do is they make the mistake of trying to build consensus after they've got the solution, when in fact you need the stakeholders to be part of that conversation. So you don't want to become disconnected from a group of people, because when they're so far behind you, they're going to slow you down. So you want to do that as a way to create value for your client. Okay, now you might just go through the motions for proposing and presenting, but that's not a good way to do it, because you have to serve the people sitting in that room. So what are you going to do? You're going to remind them that their current state is no longer tenable. Then you're going to remind them that the future is better for them and there's a way that they can get there. Then you're going to share with them exactly how you'll get them there. And you're going to go into great detail and you're going to resolve everyone's concerns in the room so that you get a yes. That's what you're trying to do. Now there's two more things. So you're going to end up negotiating, and you think negotiating means I have to defend my price. What you have to defend is the client's investment that they're making. And when they take money out of their own program, that's why they don't get good results. They think that they're taking it from you, but what they're doing is depriving you of having the money to invest in their solution. So part of negotiation is helping them understand, I don't want you to underinvest in your solution. So you think you're taking this from me, but it's going to limit what anybody can do for you. And you'll know this if you've ever lost to a competitor who failed the client and then they come right back. It's because they did not charge enough to be able to deliver that. That's just how it goes. And then finally, you're going to get ink on paper. And when you get ink on paper, now you're responsible for execution. So you're going to create tremendous value, and then you're going to go from value to value, generating more value for that client, and then growing the client, and hopefully you sell in such a way that you own the relationship for the rest of your life. Okay, I'm Anthony Iannarino. If you've not signed up for the newsletter, there's some place here on this blog that you'll find that. Put your email address in, your first name, your last name, and we will keep you up to date on everything that we're doing. And now go do good work, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.